When I accepted the assignment up here, we were told to bring a couple of personal items. Some psychological study said it helped when you're away from Earth this long. I brought my grandmother's old abacus. I would play with it on her lap, and she'd teach me the Russian for all the numbers. She, just got word that she passed. The next shuttle isn't for 3 months, so I won't be able to go to the funeral. Goodbye, Babushka. Thank you for teaching me math. It brought me to the moon.
Nova Galactic Project Log, Principal Engineer Lang Shu. Voltaire is being reconfigured for this new initiative. The math we're being asked to crunch is ambitious, even for a supercomputer. We might as well be asking it to count every grain of sand in every desert on Earth. Who came up with these original equations? Our partner isn't being very open about it. Every question I have goes through some discretionary channel. I'm surprised we even know we're working on a ship.
Voltaire really is something else. A supercomputer so powerful, they put it on the damn moon to keep it cool. Although by that logic, they should be running it purely in the vacuum of space. But hey, good marketing material. I've been spending some off hours running some dumb simulations, just because I can. My favorite so far is simulating the sound of every duck on Earth quacking after receiving a piece of bread. You didn't know you wanted a real-time sim of feeding all the ducks, but now you have it. You're welcome, humanity.
Nova Galactic Project Log, Principal Engineer Lang Shu. I admit, this is not the most disciplined team I've ever run. Malcolm keeps stealing computational time on Voltaire, and thinks I don't know this. And Sabina's been distracted lately, but won't tell anyone why. I really should demand answers from both of them. But honestly, I'm too preoccupied with this contract. We all are. Despite anything going on in our personal lives, there's something special about what we're building here.
Okay, confession time. Being single on a moon base is the worst. I only get like an hour to use the communication link to Earth every couple of days. And let me tell you, there's long-distance dating, and then there's like long-distance dating, you know? Oh, hey there. I'm a scientist, deadly employed, willing to take you out for coffee in like 6 months when I'm back from space. It's not a great opening line.
You seriously can't get a date? You're an astronaut.
Hey, no one asked you. Jealous? You know, the crew in the shipyard? Building the actual vessels that are gonna travel the stars?
We're literally on a base on the moon.
Oh, come on, Sabina. I'm trying to share my dreams here.
Well, your dreams are always out there and never here where the rest of us live. Can't you just be happy doing your job?
Where's the fun in that?
Engine spin-up time almost complete. Total time, 5 minutes, 22 seconds. Right on schedule.
How are the Helium-3 valves holding, Nova?
We double-checked the leakage concerns this morning before the launch. All signs green.
Any changes to the calculation sequence from Voltaire?
No changes since we uploaded the last figures yesterday. It's a clean shot from here to Jupiter.
One day the computer will be on board the spaceship. Just imagine that.
One miracle of science at a time, Canaveral. Counting down in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Canaveral, are you reading?
All clear, Nova. Indicators look good. The ship should be cruising Jupiter's orbit right now. Visual confirmation will be possible in 32 minutes. Afraid the speed of light is on the slow side these days.
How does it feel to break the laws of physics, Canaveral?
We're all pretty excited down here in NASA, I won't lie.
Excited enough to tell me where you got the original data?
Not in a million years.
Judith Tatien. The recent delivery from Mars is unsettling. I was station log. Dr. Judith Tatien. Station log. Dr. Judith Tatien. I have never been so nervous since I defended my dissertation. 4 hours talking to Victor and his team about theoretical metals, atomic bonding, even a half hour divergence into magnetism that I'm pretty sure was just to throw me off the trail of what we were actually talking about. Then to see the lab. I don't know how much I should say, but the periodic table just got thrown out the window.
just don't understand where these calculations came from.
There's something wrong with the math. I think it's quite straightforward.
That's not what I'm asking. We've had no success extracting even a sample of material from the object. No explanation for the gravitational effects. No motion graph to explain its harmonic frequencies. I can't even establish a melting point.
Judith.
But you've had me building these prototype colliders for months. And now you want me to pump helium-3 into it based on this equation you've written on a goddamn napkin?
I just need you to trust me.
I have been trusting you. We keep slamming our heads against a brick wall, getting nothing. And you keep coming up with something new to try. Like, you know what's going to happen. Where are you getting your information, Victor?
I'm sorry, Judith. Look, not here, okay? Somewhere off base. I'll tell you everything. But I'm not lying, okay? We're going to discover something important here. I promise. Project Log. Dr. Victor...
Project Log. Dr. Judith Tetzian. I watched the gravjet test from the moon today. It was the first time we were able to talk to the team at Nova Galactic directly. So many things were under wraps before, but now everyone wants all the publicity they can get. I'm already seeing proposals for manufacturing androids of drives, expeditions to Alpha Centauri and beyond. It's also overwhelming and worrying. It could take years, decades, before we know what all these side effects of operating a grav drive can be, but no one wants to hear that right now. Like a bunch of pioneers racing towards the edges of the frontier without knowing about the grizzly bears in the mountains.
Actually got to visit your labs back when we were working on the grav drive projects.
I know what I'm seeing.
My name is Dr. Victor Isa, and if you're listening to this, then you probably already know the truth. I was young when I first headed the retrieval team of an odd gravitational anomaly on Mars, but I kept what really happened that day hidden from everyone except one other person. Even she didn't believe me at first. But I have no reason to lie to anyone now, so I hope you'll accept this confession, whoever you are. When I touched the anomaly, I experienced 12 days of lost time. I met myself. He told me everything that has since come true. The grav drive equations, the tests on the moon, Earth's atmosphere sputtering away because of what we had done. But he also told me about a city thriving on a planet orbiting a distant star. Human culture, art, music, lifestyles evolving and shining brightly across all of space. What price would I be willing to pay for that future? Maybe you don't believe me. Maybe Judith was right and I'm just a coward who wants to believe his mistakes were justified. But everyone has forgotten about the real origins of the grav drive, this artifact from Mars. I hope you make better use of it than I did.
Thank you. them.
Do you understand now why I asked you to come here? The artifacts unlocked the secret of interstellar travel, at the cost of Earth.
An easy trade, honestly. Why have one world when you can have all the settled systems?
Don't you see? The power of the artifact forced humanity to the stars. They didn't get to make a choice. How many would have chosen Earth? What gave Victor Isa the right to choose for them?
You see the hypocrisy in what the Emissary is saying, right? They don't want to rob people of their free will, but then they steal the artifacts for themselves.
In the wrong hands, the power of the artifacts can make anyone a tyrant. That's why we watch over them. The only thing you're watching out for is yourself. Join me, old friend. We can collect the final pieces together.
Oh, no, you don't. You're not his old friend, remember? You're from another universe. Don't try to manipulate him. Okay. I couldn't win you over on philosophy. How about pragmatism? I'm more powerful than the Emissary. Than any other Starborn. And you might not understand why, but I want you to succeed. You've never gotten this far before. I need to see what happens to you. Well, look at that. The Emissary just became my new best friend.
You've made your choice. When you're ready, the Hunter and I will be at the buried temple. That's where we'll settle things.
Meaning, we'll kill you. But hey, at least we'll wait. The final round doesn't start until there's only one artifact left to gather. And if I'm not mistaken, Constellation has one or two to go.